Astronaut Michael Barrett spent more than 6 months on the International Space Station, making him well qualified for his current job as manager of NASA's Human Research Program, studying the effects of space on the human body.
The rush of fluids that are normally kept in your lower body by gravity all of a sudden are free to move up to your chest and up to your head, and it feels like you're hanging on the monkey bars.
Upside down.
Upside down, that's right.
Barrett, a medical doctor, says a more serious problem is that months in zero gravity can leave bones brittle and muscles weak. Fortunately, there's a simple solution, vigorous exercise that offsets the loss of muscle and bone mass.
It feels just like you're in the gym, and we work on squats very, very hard, as well as upper body work.
That exercise helped astronaut Tom Marshburn get through four strenuous spacewalks.
When I finished my five-month mission, I was able to stand up, walk a straight line, and it's quite an accomplishment. We had not been able to do that before.
When not in space, Marshburn works on the strength and dexterity needed for spacewalks in a giant pool at the Johnson Space Center in Houston. But some effects of space on the human body don't have simple answers.
It's safe to say that radiation is our biggest concern.
It is, the
by
biggest.
Far. Radiation, unfortunately, the spaceflight environment is a radiation environment.
Radiation, much of it from solar flares, can increase the risk of cancer.
How can you reduce the risk?
The ultimate countermeasure would actually be speed.
Speed?
Absolutely.
How does speed reduce radiation?
Because it limits our time in deep space.
Flying to Mars with today's technology would take 6 months.
Well, what if we could fly there in a couple of months, a few weeks? That helps our radiation profile tremendously.
That kind of speed, though, is a long way off. But for astronauts, the lure of space travel overwhelms medical concerns.
Would you go to Mars if you had the opportunity?
Like that.
Let me go ahead and connect that.
A manned mission to the red planet won't happen for more than 15 years, but at the Johnson Space Center, they're already waiting in line. Chip Reed, CBS News, Houston.